started the concept of consumer equilibrium using the utility approach in the case of two commodities in this lecture. It can be extended to two or more commodities as well. Now, Marshall explained the concept of consumer equilibrium in the case of two or more commodities with the help of the law of equi-marginal utility. Now, the law states that consumer gets maximum satisfaction when he consumes different commodities up to a point that the marginal utility from consumption of each one of them is the same. That is, Marshall used the concept of law of equi-marginal utility to find out the condition of the consumer equilibrium in the case of two commodities, which is as follows, which is like marginal utility of commodity X divided by price of commodity X is equal to marginal utility of price of commodity Y divided by price of commodity Y is equal to the marginal utility of the last rupee spent on each good. Now, what is marginal utility of law of equi-marginal utility say? It says that the consumer will derive maximum satisfaction when he consumes two commodities. In this case, is X and Y are the two commodities, such that the marginal utility from each one of them is equal to the marginal utility of the last rupee spent on each good. Basically, we are looking for a condition where marginal utility of X is equal to marginal utility of Y. So let us take an example here. We say that the consumer's income is 5 rupees and he is consuming two commodities, say A and B, where the price of commodity A and price of commodity B is equal to rupees 1. Now the question that we want to ask is, how should the consumer allocate his expenditure on two goods such that consumer equilibrium is reached and he is maximizing his total utility? When he has 5 rupees and the price of each commodity is rupees 1. Now, this is the commodity in units, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This is the marginal utility from the consumption of commodity A and marginal utility from the consumption of commodity B. Now, when you have a money income of rupees 5, you see that the maximum marginal utility that you get is from consumption of the first unit of commodity A. Then you see that the next best that you can get is 9, because 9 is greater than 8, 8 is, and 9 is greater than 6. So you will consume commodity B. One unit of commodity A is consumed, the other unit of commodity B is consumed. Now you are left with rupees 3 as your income. Now from your income of rupees 5, you spend 2, left with 3. Now you see the maximum marginal utility that you get is from commodity 1. Commodity A, so you consume the second unit of this commodity and derive a marginal utility of 8. Similarly, now you see that marginal utility from consumption of commodity B and C and A is the same. That is, marginal utility of consumption of commodity B, second unit of commodity B, is equal to the marginal utility of consumption from this commodity A. Okay, so what is it that you've spent rupees 5 now? 1 rupee has been spent on first unit of commodity, 1 rupee on first unit of B commodity, 1 rupee on second unit of A commodity, 1 rupee on second unit of B commodity, and 1 rupee on the third unit of commodity A. So the total utility that you get from A is 10 plus 8 plus 6, and the total utility that you get from commodity B is 9 plus 6. So the total utility from the consumption of the commodity is 39. So you see that you've spent all your money income, that is, you've spent all the 5 rupees, and you attained a total utility of 39, and you will notice that the marginal utility of commodity A and marginal utility of commodity B is equal to 6. This is the condition of consumer equilibrium in the case of two commodity according to the law of EP, marginal utility. Therefore, this is the equilibrium. Now, if you are spending, if you spend your income in any other way other than this combination, you will see that the total utility that you derive will fall. Let us take an example. The example is, if you spend all your money on commodity A, then you will get a total utility of 10 plus 8 plus 6 plus 4 plus 2, which is equal to 30. Then after that, from B, you will get 9 plus 6 plus 4 plus 2 plus 0, which is equal to 22. You notice that from the optimal consumption, you are getting the total utility of 39. But if you spend it like that, the total utility from the commodity falls. And if you see that if instead of consuming, spending the last money on commodity A, you spend the last 1 rupee on commodity B, then the total utility will fall by 2 units. Why? Because you will gain 4 but you are losing 6. So the total utility will be 37 in that case. So you notice that you have to see that what is the marginal utility, maximum marginal utility that you get while spending that money income. And the second thing that you need to check is that whether the marginal utility from commodity A is equal to commodity B. Okay, now it is very clear. I'll again repeat the law of EP, marginal utility. It says that marginal utility from commodity A should be equal to marginal utility of commodity B. If this is satisfied, then the consumer will maximize his total utility. If this condition is not satisfied, then the consumer's total utility will fall. In the next video, we will cover the concept of budget line, indifference curve, and we'll find out the consumer equilibrium using the indifference curve method.